It's been a long journey. Appalachia has changed. I don't know if you've been following the rumors, but there's something in the mountains. People from outside are coming in, and they're coming to stay.
To this for me.
We ain't gonna let anyone stand in our way.
I need you, all of you, to do your part.
Well, howdy everybody. This is the continuation of Places Before the Big Change Comes on April 7th. This time it's really creepy because it's the Kanawha County Church, which you get to by going to the Kanawha County Cemetery, which this is what you see when you fast travel here. I'm here with my right-hand man, my cohort in crime, my wasteland bro.
That's me.
Troy.
Howdy, bro. Cohort, all those things you just said and more.
Exactly. So this place is kind of creepy anyway, but it's getting ready. It's fixing to really get creepy. The first thing when you fast travel here, this is exactly what you see. So you're right outside the cemetery. There's all kinds of resources and things you can get while you're here. Won't go into all those details, but it's just a really creepy place to be. There's bugs and ghouls and good Lord, what things have we met the times that we've been here?
It seems like blowflies and stings.
Yeah, blowflies. Yeah, bugs. Exactly. Oh,
ticks.
Ticks.
Lots of ticks.
There's a tick. Speaking of bugs.
Yeah.
It's a good place to farm, bags of cement? That tick
I believe it's
my...
cement. Or fertilizer. Yeah, I think cement. Yeah.
Yes. I don't think it's in here, but anyhow, this kind of gives away a little of what's getting ready to happen. Is you start seeing these Mothman effigies all over the place and bugs. Anyhow, that's not what we're here for. We're here for this, the church. The Kanawha County Church. Right now, from a distance, it doesn't look that opposing or anything. But come April 7th, this place is going to look real different. But when you go inside this church, it really gets creepy. Because you can kind of see the signs of the things that are getting ready to happen here. It's definitely was a hangout for Mothman cultists, but was abandoned, and apparently it's not going to be abandoned April 7th. You walk in and you get the creep vibe. I got to turn my light off so you can get the ambiance of this very creepy. Why can't I go on? What's going on here? There we go. Yeah, you see the Mothman attire, the effigies and different things. It's like, okay, this place is really weird.
Statues.
Yeah, and then you see the
dead mole rat.
Yeah, you see the dead people, and they're all like, you're like, what is going on here? And one thing you notice. See the cups. Everybody's got glasses, and you kind of get an idea.
They drank the Kool-Aid.
Yeah, they drank the Kool-Aid. This is like a cult thing going on here. They all drank of the Kool-Aid. See the empty glasses. It's just really, really creepy in here. But. It's definitely, yeah, and you see the glasses up here. It's like, everybody grab a glass. Everybody gets Kool-Aid. and you see the effigy.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's not communion wine.
No, that's definitely not communion wine. It's kind of funny because you can sit here and you can play the piano. I don't know. I guess that's their joke. But yeah, I just thought I'd take a final walk through here, what this place looks like now, because the clips that I'm showing, it's like gonna be root infested, and just really the creep vibe is gonna go through the roof here. I mean, it's already creepy. I mean, look at this. Oh my gosh. Look at the dead body on the pike, and just, it's just a really creepy place. But it's really going to get creepy April 7th. I mean, this is probably going to be one of the creepiest changes of the game. But yeah, the Mothman cultists are definitely making a huge comeback. I didn't notice these pikes here. I guess those are pikes or spikes or whatever you call them to impale people. God, this place
there
is just,
something.
Yeah, this place is so creepy. But yeah, the pictures from what we're seeing, yeah, this place is going to be completely entangled in roots. I'm not quite sure. It might be, what's that, that funky creature down in the, where was that, the Lucky Hole Mine? That secret place where that crazy weird creature is laying dormant, but he twitches every once in a while.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, isn't that the, sure where it's like the secret spot of the Lucky Hole Mine or something.
Yeah, and there are a lot of cultist stuff down there.
Yeah, a lot of cultist stuff. And I don't know if like that thing's going to come to life, and that's why this place gets entangled in roots. I'll try my best to find a clip of that creepy thing, because it's really creepy. But I think it's at the Lucky Hole Mine. Alrighty, well, here we are at the Lucky Hole Mine. I figure we'll show you real quick how to get down here and see the, it's called the Interloper. I can't believe I couldn't remember the name of that, the weird creature that lurks.
Interloper, of course. Well, you spawn in on this trail right down here. You just follow the trail to these little buildings.
Right.
And probably you're going to run into either ants or crickets, something right here.
Yeah, we ran into cave crickets.
Killed a few crickets on the way, but this little shed or pole barn looking building
is
the entrance to the mine.
Yeah,
through this door right here.
So when you come up here, see this little half dome or whatever you call it. So anyhow, let's go into the mine.
Metal barn,
danger,
I guess.
Abandoned mine, keep out. I've been warned. Another cool place about the Lucky Hole, or place, another cool thing about the Lucky Hole Mine is it's a great place to farm for lead.
Oh my goodness, you can get so much lead coming down to this place.
Lots and lots and lots of lead, but that's not why we're here. We're just going to go in here and show you where the really weird, it really
make sure you
weird.
Undo these can chimes or else the cultists just might come after
you. They just might hear you. And then the next thing you know, you'll be a cultist.
If you're not already.
But it's...
Oh, cultist statue number one right off the bat.
Yeah, there's a lot of funkiness in here. I better...
I hear what I think might be mole miners with missile launchers or something.
Yes.
Crickets.
And I'll probably die two or three times through here because... Uh-oh. Heck, while I'm doing this, even though my HUD, I can't see it, I can... I'm not...
And this little sign...
For, waste acid.
If anybody knows why this little sign of a turtle is here, I would like to know your take on it. It makes me curious every time I come down here, why that turtle is there.
Okay, there's another.
There's some old miners down there.
Thingy. Doomajigger. What is it they call those things?
Well, they're the statues, the cultist statues that come with the Mothman package. You can actually put these in your camp also.
Yeah, they got a name for them. I can't think of what they call them. Ooh, kill a mole miner. Hey, I got 10 atoms.
Oh, yeah, that's one of the challenges today, the dailies.
But here's another effigy.
Yeah, that's from
a lot off. There you go. Now you get the creepy vibe of this place. Yeah, somewhere down through here, you pick up. It's kind of an overgrown, mossy. You walk right by it.
Yeah, there's actually an altar and a bigger area that where you can tell they did the meetings.
Yeah, so here's more
held
another
cultist church meetings or whatever you want to say.
It's just uber creepy down here.
It seems like there is the place I'm talking about might be behind these doors, because you have to have the lucky hole mine key to get through this door back here.
There's another cultist thing.
Yep.
Yeah, all along these walls, there's where the lead deposits.
Lead and everywhere. Crystal. Yeah.
Yeah.
Lots of crystal as well.
So young and so fine, and seek not your fortune. This is really creepy down here. Of course, what mine isn't.
Yeah, here it is. Here's the church right here.
Yeah.
This is the main church area.
I mean, how creepy is this place? It's dark as of course, when you light it up, you really see some creepiness. Just, where the danger, I don't know, the creep meter. Oh, and there's a statue. These are creepy, too. Everything's creepy.
This statue is pretty awesome.
It's dark, but, as a dungeon. Yeah, we're getting close to it. Let's see if I can... I want to do this quick. I don't want to, because I want to insert this, and I don't want it to be real.
Yeah, right.
But you go down these tunnels, and it's just off to the side. It's just kind of a... Okay, you get to this part here where the keypad door, you don't have to go through here. But you want to backtrack. And you want to go back. There's this little split. I mean, you can't hardly see that it's there, but it's there. You want to go through here. You got to be really careful because it's covered over. It doesn't even look like you can go through it.
The little telltale sign are these roots right here. I think you just walked past it.
Yeah,
nope.
See?
That's not it, but it's like that.
Yeah.
Here it is, right here, this root here.
Yeah, see these roots here? You can't even tell that you can get through there, but you can walk through it. And here is the really creepy, creepy place where the interloper rests. Unless they rest, because he's not dead. He keeps twitching every once in a while. This place. Just the creep factor is off.
Don't wake him up.
Exactly, yeah. You get that feeling. It's like, God, please, let's not wake him up. And there he is. The interloper. In this really, really, really creepy place. And he looks like he's made out of roots. And it kind of looks like the roots that's on the church. And I don't know what to make out of it. It's just the strangest look. See, look at him move. Oh God, he twitches. And there's more of those heads. But yeah, this is just, this is the interloper. This is the creepy dude. Anyhow, I just wanted to add that into the, see y'all, and you look at all of the, I guess, sacrifices. Yeah, this place is really...
Look at all these faces, the statues back here.
Yeah, the faces. Let me turn the light off so you really get a the creep factor in here. We got these candles. And the music in here. It's just... Everything is just so weird. But yeah, you can see it's really hard to get down here. And this thing is like... Just really strange looking. Can't tell.
It's not
where.
Necessarily hard to get to, but it's easy
it's
to
tricky.
Miss.
Yeah, it's really easy to miss. But anyhow, yeah, this is the creepy root looking dude that's called the interloper. So we're going to see, and then you can see the mason jars, I guess, with poison. So apparently people come in here and they've been sacrificing themselves to him.
Yeah, that's what it looks like, but, for sure.
Yeah, this is
the faces creep me out even more though. It's like they look almost alien or I don't know, something
very
made by force. Another society or
Yeah, it reminds me of the Institute. It's just really I don't know, just really some strange stuff going on here. Anyhow, I'm gonna throw this in so y'all can get an idea where and what we're talking about. So, back to the video. Now, there's some more spikes, I guess, for impaling people. They really like impaling people in here. I guess this is one of them places, is if you used to be walking by here and they ask you, hey, are you a fan of the Mothman? So, like, heck yeah, I am. Please don't impale me.
People that aren't?
Yeah. So, yeah, just a quick walkthrough of this, because it's really, this place is really fixing to get weird. But this is what it looked like before, so if you're watching this after April 7th, this is it. It's kind of empty. Apparently it's not going to be empty anymore. I don't know if they're going to be serving fresh Kool-Aid, but if they do, my suggestion is don't drink it.
I'm glad to see that they're actually incorporating a lot of the Mothman cultist stuff with the update, which they're obviously doing, because they show that clip of the one in the new trailer.
It's really going to be interesting. So anyhow, that's just a quick walkthrough of the Kanawha County Church. And here's what it looks like now. And I'll have a picture of what it's fixing to look like. Roots and stuff. I mean, it's really going to be infested with roots and stuff. It's going to really look weird. But that in a nutshell, that's it. So anyhow, oh, kitty cat sneezing. Anyhow, God bless
you,
y'all.
Kitty cat.
Bless you, kitty cat.
And bless you people out there whopping.
Bless you people. And April 7th, I'll tell you, it's building. It's getting more and more exciting the closer this gets. So, we're all going to see what happens
excited.
April. Yeah. And actually, if you're watching this now, this coming weekend, what's it called? There's an event they're going to be at, and they're going to be showing clips of actual play, gameplay. So we might actually get a sneak peek even sooner, see what this place is going to look like.
Yeah, I hope they release some footage from that. It's...
No,
some kind
sure
of electronics event, or kind of like a CES type thing, I think.
Yeah,
I can't remember what they call it though.
I'll have a picture of it, because I'll look it up to what it, whatever it's called this weekend. Plus, remember, this weekend is double XP, so for you new players, double XP weekends are the perfect opportunity to rank up really quick.
Absolutely.
Higher ranked players like us, it's like, it's kind of cool, but it's not as cool as it used to be. Like when you're like level 25 and you're like, oh my God, it's double XP weekend is a godsend. Because I think Yes. In one double XP weekend, I think we ranked up from like level 30 to almost level 100. I mean, it seemed like it. I don't know if we did.
Yeah,
maybe we got up to level 50. But
yeah, it did seem like we went from 30 to 50 in no time. Yeah.
But anywho, that's it in a nutshell. God bless y'all for watching or for hanging out and whatever's going on.
Good seeing y'all again.
Good seeing y'all.
Remember, this is the place to come for your Fallout Wastelanders
updates.
That's
right. For your Wastelander updates.
It's all over, but the crying. And I can't get over crying.